you're a Bharatiya nari, showing even a little bit of cleavage or leg will get you reactions like, ये कैसे कपड़े पहने? But why?
ऐसे कपड़े पहनकर घर आई है, तो मुंबई में तो नंगी घूमती होगी।
Revealing clothes weren't considered vulgar in ancient India. Excavated figurines and temple art reveal that nude bodies were even worshipped. Historians often trace a widespread shift in this attitude to the Delhi Sultanate in medieval India. Elite women's movement in public spaces became restricted, and they were required to observe a ghoonghat or parda in public. Women's clothes became a matter of their family's honor, and elite households created zananas or dedicated and protected spaces for women. This cultural practice was further strengthened in the north during Mughal rule. Nonetheless, in other parts of the country like Bengal and southern India, women didn't observe this practice and many of them wore saris without covering their breasts. In the 18th century, Victorian notions of propriety ended up influencing women's dressing across the country. The British considered draping the sari without a blouse vulgar. Gyanda Nandini Devi, who belonged to an elite Bengali family, ended up popularizing wearing the sari with blouses or jackets after she was denied entry to British clubs bare-chested. From the mid-19th century, as feminist movements emerged and British notions of morality evolved, it became acceptable for Western women to wear more revealing clothes. At the same time in India, in discourse around nationalist movements like Swadeshi, the binary of the good Indian woman and the bad Western woman emerged. The good woman covered her body and was associated with domesticity, docility, and good upbringing. The dichotomy was reinforced in early Hindi cinema, where the heroine was the good sanskari covered-up girl, while the woman who wore revealing outfits was always the westernized vamp, with her short clothes, nightclubs, drinking, smoking, and other vices that made her a bad influence on the hero. As the Indian economy began to open up in the 1980s and 90s, we saw a shift in Hindi cinema. The good versus bad woman binary ceased to exist, and the heroine too began wearing revealing clothes. A booming global beauty and fashion industry had to sell the image of the modern Indian woman who could wear short clothes and still be respectable. And so, through cinema, beauty pageants, and advertisements, a new notion of the liberated modern Indian woman became aspirational. Newly emerging women consumers in cities embraced the freedom to show their skin, but the cultural tensions around women's clothing still remained strong. Practices like ghoonghat and covering their bodies has become even more important for many rural Indian women, who now view this as a marker of their dehati honor. Women who don't wear the ghoonghat are denigrated with insults like besharam or nangi. And unfortunately, even though wearing short clothes may be seen as more acceptable in Indian cities, it is still seen as risky behavior. An 8-city survey found that 50% of urban Indian men between 15 and 29 believe that a woman wearing short clothes is inviting rape. Indian politicians often blame victims of sexual assault and violence for attracting men because of their indecent clothing. Conservative groups have attacked film and TV sets, protesting against women's attire and attacking their characters based on their clothing. But here's the thing. Studies from around the world have shown that women's clothing has little to no impact on whether they're at the receiving end of sexual violence. In fact, women are more likely to face sexual assault within their homes than they are outside. People around the world are calling bullshit on this misguided policing. Through social media campaigns, art installations, and awareness-raising efforts on the ground, we are questioning not only these false notions of respectability, but also the arbitrariness of what body parts we choose to police when. Whether it's freeing the nipple on Instagram or protesting against sexist uniforms, what we're asserting is women taking control of their own sexuality and demanding the right to wear what we want, when we want. That's it for this video in the Overthinking It series. If you like Overthinking with us, please don't forget to hit like, share, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you stay updated.